'Cause I'm a stranger. Chickity chick 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 check. Check 1 2. We are here live back here at the High Vibe TV studios. Let's make sure that we are in the chats on High Vibe TV, the app. Are you on it? That's where it's popping. We got the fam up in there. What's going on, High Vibe? Of course, we are streaming this to YouTube, the lifeboat for the last people before. They're already banning everything else, natural, holistic stuff, everything. So what do you think's next? It's good to be with you all. Let me get, I guess I'll check YouTube chat now. There we go. What's going on, everyone? It's good to be back. I'm your host, DJ Astrologer David Palmer, and I am here for Spiritual Dance Music, which, of course, we do here live at the High Vibe TV studios. So happy to be back here. We do this on the new moon and full moons, and we are here to, of course, talk the astrology, go into the tarot, give you a prayer, and channel that all into a live dance music mix. And when I mean live, I mean live. Thanks so much for the love. Everybody in the chat saying congrats on being a father. You should be giving. We all need to give our congrats, and I have to give my appreciation to my fiance Sophia for being such a great mom. She had to push baby Aurora out and carry her for 9 months and continue to be the one that allows her to survive through breastfeeding. Isn't that an amazing thing? Just to say it like that. People don't even talk like that anymore. It's really wild. And everybody, we should all thank Anne. She is in the house tonight. Dr. Anne Wolke behind producing this show tonight for me live, late. So many things happening today. I know Mercury just came out of retrograde. This new moon did not have Mercury come out of retrograde. It was when the moon finally ingressed into Libra. So this is to me more of a, I'm back. Took off my maternity leave, even though I really didn't take much maternity leave, but I needed to take care of a lot of things, and it's going to be back, and we're celebrating Mercury station direct and only five planets retrograde. And yes, a new moon in Virgo that is trine to Uranus and Taurus. Now, I covered this all over, especially Deep Astrology or all the shows on High Vibe. I'm going to keep this one simple. This is not a seeding new moon. This is starting to see all the seeds you've been planting and how they are all are starting to come together. We're in five planets retrograde. Don't get yourself stuck on this new thing. Everything has a past to it right now that is coming into your life to come together. Work you've already done, things you've already come into, and that you've seeded prior. So the seeding is the understanding and the knowledge of seeing it and the magical wonders. And to be honest with you, it's a great transit because it's one that realizes that what you thought were so big of issues right now are not really that big a deal compared to what you maybe a week ago, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago thought. So, but of course, the world is about to go, it's already gone to that crazy place, but let's just now add to it that we have the equinox next week. That's why here at the High Vibe TV studios, we are doing Euphoric Equinox, a live event here in person where you can get tickets. They're super cheap, $30. We're looking for people from LA, Orange County, San Diego to have the best equinox ever. We're also live streaming it. You can go to highvibe.tv, click on Euphoric Equinox. It's going to be awesome. Rich Lopp and I are going to be doing our show, The Awakening Experience, live on the stage. Dr. Ann Wolke and I, Natalie, Leia, and Rich. That's Leia is Rich's wife. They're going to be doing an awesome healing sessions. And then, of course, you know, we have a lot of other surprises. Rich is going to be on his guitar, sing some songs. We also have Alex Skiles here. He's going to be doing some music. And then, of course, Spiritual Dance Music live in person. All going to be awesome. Doesn't matter where you are. I know it's hard for some people to travel right now, but I made the event super cheap. And really, it's about the message of us carrying the highest vibrations through this fall. This fall is going to have a lot of nasty, craziest stuff we've ever seen in our lives. And so this is us pushing that positive energy out there and all of us doing it as a community. So really looking forward to it. This is something that Rich and I came up with weeks ago. And all of us at High Vibe have really come together for it. We're doing an awesome, you know, the ladies touch. Lay and Sophia have been talking about all the cool new decorations and even this really cool new spiritual hallway coming into the event that we put a lot of cool stuff into. So we're really making, you know, this place is the spiritual wonderland. So if you really want to come for an awesome experience for $30 for a full night event for the Equinox, it's here at High Vibe TV Studios in Huntington Beach. Go to highvibe.tv. So really that's what this new moon's about with the trine to Uranus, is everything coming together that you've already been seeding. And remember, Jupiter and Uranus, those two are coming together in Taurus season of 2024, and they're going to conjunct at 21 degrees of Taurus. So this new moon was at 21 degrees just the day ago, and now, boom, it made an exact trine to that Jupiter-Uranus. So this is stuff that has already been seeded when the North Node and Uranus were together a year ago in August into September. And now you're starting to see those things come together. And then these things that come together are going to be the biggest blossom you've ever seen in your life come Taurus season of 2024. If you're trying to find some new thing that you've never found before and you're looking around how my little baby daughter's looking around to see the world, like, what is happening next? Even though she's so smart, she's already past that point. But if you want to be a little baby infant right now spiritually, guess what? You don't know what you're doing. You're still trying to find something that you can't find. You need to look at what you've been doing and what you've been seeding. And that this is not as lost territory as you might think it is. All of the lost territory is how much you are depriving yourself of actually staying on top of things, doing the work. And staying on top of things is pretty simple in life. You just keep doing it. You find the pattern. You find the wave. Even if it's all crazy, you find a way to do it. The Saturn and Neptune Pisces we haven't seen since 1523. So it's really easy to get sloppy. It's really easy to get tired or, you know, I don't want to do it. You know, it's like one of those things in life with Pluto Capricorn still. The ones that are going to make it through without being lumped up into a paper mache Mexican alien factory are the ones that keep the integrity and do the work. But the ones that want to be lazy right now and I don't know where I'm going and just want to keep going through breakup after breakup and just go on your next Bumble date. And you know, maybe you should go try and date one of those Mexican alien paper mache aliens. I'm sure they have all the answers for you. I mean, you know, they got the guy that was just cleaning in the back to put on a white lab coat and sit in front of it. He didn't even know what was going on. So this is definitely a time to where you can be a paper mache alien and have that look on your face. I mean, you know, they say Hunter Biden is the child of Joe Biden. I think, no, that paper mache alien, the sixth booster, seventh booster, just finally he was able. And in this world, it's okay. He's able to have a baby. He had it. They just showed it. And it's got the same face. It's got the same facial features. You know that. Once you become a father in this world, when you see your baby coming out, you just know by the way that that face looks. And when I saw that little baby paper mache alien, I just went, geez, that's Joe Biden's baby. And, you know, it just took genetic engineering and re-engineering into yourself so many times at CVS and Walgreens. I think he rotated between a couple until finally paper mache came out. So congratulations, Joe Biden. Super happy for you. This is another grandkid that you are going to deny. And I'm really looking forward to you finding that spiritual place within yourself to really see that you already dropped all those beautiful seeds and look what came out. So take your advice from the leader of the free world out there, because he's definitely showing us the way. I'll be back one sec. We'll pull the tarot. And I do recommend not to stare into the eyes. If you've ever been on Indiana Jones, the ride at Disneyland, whenever you come into the temple, look into my eyes. Don't look into the eyes of the paper mache alien. You might just turn into paper mache yourself. Be right back. ¶¶ Yeah, definitely sow the seeds. But it's okay to cuss. Remember that it's psychologically proven that people that cuss are the most honest, transparent, and real. And the people who don't cuss are the biggest liars in the world. Look it up. Those paper mache aliens don't fucking cuss. I get the opposite. So think about that, all the haters out there. At least I don't bore you. Shit. Let's see what's in the tarot pulling up for this new moon with Mercury that's stationed direct after the new moon, fully, completely after the new moon, wasn't even connected. Can't believe so many people were trying to connect these. Ugh. Ten of Wands upright. So we got the Ten of Wands up here. This is definitely... it's going to feel like a huge push, especially we got the eclipses coming up here on the next new moon that comes up here in less than one whole lunar cycle. But, you know, it's definitely a card that it's everything that you got to make it to that finish line in life. And, you know, it could feel like a lot of heavy weight on top of us. But, you know, if you're going to feel like this is just too much, I need to drop all this and I need to make myself feel more free. What are you going to do when Pluto comes direct in Capricorn in October with all these eclipse energies coming and shit? You know, you got to hold the line with keep going and doing the work and doing, especially from your passions. We got a Six of Wands here in reversed. Yeah, it's going to feel like it's not just a moment of victory island here of life. You just didn't reach the this is the quest that hasn't ended. I feel like people are just wanting the quest to end and like, can I have my trophy? And then what are you going to go do? Go home and sit and watch Netflix and shit? Run home, wait for your Amazon package? You still playing that, like, fucking weird COVID game? See how they indoctrinated people now? It's like, oh my gosh, can't wait to go run home. I just saw an article today that says that 73% of all people in America don't go out to dinners with coworkers anymore. I was like, whoa. They indoctrinate people to run home to feel like that they're in some sort of safe zone where it's like, it's fucking weird. It's like, oh my gosh, you didn't wear a mask. Fucking. But that's kind of sad to see out there. And I feel like people are just wanting the victory more than the whole experience. Like, sorry to say, the victory is death. That's the moment where we look back in our life and go, fuck yeah, that was the best journey ever. The idea of I need to win and I need to get my happiness now, but I don't want to have to push through the, like the pushing through is the same way. I know people are pissed that I'm fucking talking always about the birth canal since I just became a father, but it's like watching that shit is magical. Like, you know, like watching women and my, especially my woman, push our daughter out. It takes everything that you got for life. That's how we all had to come out, or we got chopped out. It doesn't matter how we came out. There's so much intensity there, and that's what makes life. So, you know, this is a time for the big things that we are going to see that have not only been seeded in the timelines we've been jumping. You have to realize we've been all jumping timelines with that North Node Uranus conjunction last year at this time. And so now we're here at this place where we're seeing the trines to Uranus without the North Node, but with Jupiter here to really bring us the abundance. But they're both retrograde saying, like, look at everything starting to come together that you've already seeded a year ago, or even ideas that you planted in 2011 when Jupiter was in Taurus and when it finally stationed retrograde. So this is like the last 12 years and all these other things that have happened in the last year, all starting to Uranus come together. Even stuff from 2018 into 2019 when Uranus came and it ingressed into Taurus, ingressed back into Aries, and then in 2019 at the beginning, ingressed back into Taurus. And that's exactly what you'll see in the patterns. But you won't hear that anywhere else because most people are just trying to throw you some clickbait. The challenge here is the Temperance card. Oh, I just want to feel like it's a natural part of life. It's not natural. There's paper mache aliens everywhere. People are running to CVS for a fake shot thing that fucking 10 mice got. And I don't even think they're not even like mice. Look it up. They're like genetically engineered weird fucking mice. And yeah, there's weird shit going on. It's not natural. You know where we're going to get the natural is our human nature. That's why alchemy always teaches us, no matter how bad the pendulum swings to chaos and order, it's the spiritual nature. It's the divine nature. It's the human divine nature. And the spiritual divine is always it, the eternal. If you're going to get lost in this terrestrial, I mean, the motherfuckers made paper mache ET fucking dolls. I'm like, is this Amblin Entertainment? There's no Reese's Pieces. Like, with a full moon on a bicycle, treating it like it's a baby. Like, it's fucking crazy. This is not natural. Everywhere you go, it's not natural. I feel bad for people who live in Canada. That place looks like, I never thought that Canada would be like the most dangerous place in the world to go, but it is. Like, whoa. So, you know, like, it's not natural right now, but that doesn't mean that it has to be bad. If you're sitting in your natural energy, you're with the right people. This is this new moon was trine Uranus, and the sun is trine Uranus as we're doing this, as finally Mercury came stationary direct when the moon ingressed into Libra at 1 degree. This is a time for awesome people in your life to do great things. If you're trying to detach from people and you're playing with this Jupiter-Venus square for the third time, and they've been both the two benefics in square for the last 2.5 months, if you're doing the whole, like, bad luck, I feel like nobody understands me, no, these people are bad in my life, like, honestly, you got to look at yourself. You're the one that everybody's probably like, well, we gave it our best shot. Like, we really gave the compassion. We tried. But, you know, the egomaniacs are going to come out right now and try and detach from people and disconnect from people. So, you know, this is also a call to all the light workers. We all need to start coming together and doing shit. You know, I'm doing that awesome event, Stairway to the Stars, in November, the 10th, 11th, and 12th at the Luxor Casino and Hotel, with the most amazing people. There's even access to Area 51 in buses on Saturday night that we're going to go watch and go look for paper mache aliens. Now we're going to go look for the real shit. I've actually done and seen the real shit with Jimmy Church. So it's going to be fucking badass. And, you know, I'm going to be talking. So many other people are going to be there. Go check it out. Stairway to the Stars is done by Disclosure Fest and Jimmy Church. Gaia is sponsoring it as well. Make sure that you check it out. Rooms are still available. Tickets still available. Super looking forward to that. I also just got booked for Conscious Life Expo again. So you can start getting your tickets and everything for that. Conscious Life Expo in LA. It'll be the second. I think it's February 6th. Check it out date-wise. And I am doing everything there. I'm doing astrology panel. I'm doing spiritual dance music for the whole entire Conscious Life Expo, but for two nights. And I'm also doing a full workshop, and I'm doing the Monday workshops too. So that'll be in February. So there's a lot going on. I mean, the light workers are all uniting and doing things. If you feel like a light worker out there and you're not connecting, you know, this is your time to go make the connections, make things happen. Don't be afraid. Go do it. This is might feel unnatural, but really you're stepping into your true nature, not this weird terrestrial with people who are walking into Walgreens and looking for crazy shit. Ace of Swords reversed is what I'm seeing overall here. Again, I feel like this is people trying to find some sort of clarity about life when the clarity right now is in watching it show up when it does. I don't think that you should be seeking clarity. The clarity is much more clear when you watch the things that you've already been doing and you've been doing your work and you've been just finding the lifestyle that is the true divine path. I think if you're trying to force anything to understand or force to pierce through anything, you're not getting any info right now. It's like walking, you know, Anne taught me really well. Like, you just don't walk into a library and try and find a book what you're looking for. Like, you're not, it's like finding a needle in a haystack. You go into a library with an objective and a mission and understanding of what to research. And, you know, so, you know, for me, like, I've been looking at libraries and what books whenever I go to that library. Like, those are the books I want to see. Can't buy them. Can't. Okay, those are the ones. And that's where I already have a feeling and an inclination that there's going to be info in there. Ace of Swords reverse to me is people that are just blindly going, like, I need to find this place. I don't know where to go. I need to figure it out. You know, the more that you try to figure it out, you're not figuring anything out. You're just running the computer in your mind 24/7. You know, you might as well ask the paper mache aliens in Mexico, and they're not going to give you an answer. And I guarantee you, with this Juno-Venus conjunction that's squaring Jupiter retrograde, I've already said, it's like beer goggles, but it's like spiritual twin flame goggles. Like, there's people running over there thinking their twin flames are those paper mache aliens. I mean, like, they got all the answers. I already know. It's like, no, it's like, okay, like, good luck. I don't know how that's going to feel. The spiritual vice is the death card. Oh, that was kind of weird. I even said, you know, our true end of our quest and our true victory is death. You know, but this is a transformational time where we have to get over trying to figure it out. It's an unnatural feeling in place. I need to feel like I need to be victorious in order to actually be doing my spiritual work. And more importantly, all it is keep trucking. You know, this is a time where it's like, you're tired, whatever. My dad used to do a radio show in the car industry, and he used to get callers. And a lot of people, the number one call was always like, how do I keep driving? I get tired easy. My dad was like, carry eye drops with you. Get a thing of ice in your cup. Roll down your window. Put in the Visine. Chew on some ice, and then put a little bit of that cold ice on your face. Get some gum. Back in the day, there was no dose. I don't know if they still got that shit. Get a cup of coffee. But like spiritually, it's not like we have to find some external thing. It's more internally right now. Like, hey, this five planets retrograde. Venus, yeah, it's direct, but it's still slow. We got Mars in Libra. You know, energy right now is more in the magic. Who knows? You know, the true magicians are making shit happen right now without having to fucking, where do I figure it out right now? I do have the Ganesha deck, so I thought I would pull a couple Ganesha cards here. We got belonging. Sun trine Uranus. You know, I feel like a lot of people right now don't feel like they know where they belong. We always belong to the spiritual divine. We always belong to the eternal. When you go there first, then you will start to see all the superhighways to every place that you truly not just belong, but that you get to. And we got decision. It's much easier to stay with your decisions than be hanging on a decision. But, you know, these are times where are the decisions being based because you're lonely or you feel like you're lonely with your soul to the eternal? Maybe you just need to make the decision to go back to that belonging and understanding that we always belong. We didn't come down here to be alone and just be all weird and creeped out like in a coffin, being praised like the Pope now, like that are these little paper mache aliens, like with little fake eggs in them. I just don't think that that's going to be the place that you're going to find your belonging. And for love and romantic relationships, I did pull, wow, we got the Ace of Wands in reversed here. Again, I don't think that if you're trying to look for something new, I almost feel like you're, again, really lost. I also feel like, you know, this is a time where it's like you're looking for just some basic new start. Not good within yourself. You need to look in yourself more. And I got courage. This is the courage to actually find your actual heart right now. And, you know, I'm a Leo, so we stay committed. Like, so it's like, do you know how to be committed by courage and love all the time, no matter if it's a bad day or hard times or whatever? Laugh. The best part about being a dad is being able to watch my baby daughter laugh, even when she's crying because the diaper needs to be changed. She just woke up or she's hungry or whatever. It's just always so great to just, hey, it's okay, and burp her, and then look at her and be like, did you just burp? And, you know, like, if you're like, I'm unhappy, I haven't found anybody, and I'm with another paper mache alien that just didn't say anything and didn't do anything, and they projected on me, and they're an egomaniac narcissist, well, it was pretty, like, much like, well, first of all, like, were you just doing it for some clout because you wanted to be like the girl on the airplane and see that motherfucker's not real? Or maybe you actually said it was real. I don't know. But if that's where you got to find your heart, find your courage. I'll pull one more card. Queen of Cups reversed. Again, if you're seeking comfort, you're not going to get it. This is where you got to be emotionally comfortable within yourself. Anybody right now who's looking for some sort of like exterior thing to make them provide them happiness, you don't understand retrogrades. You don't understand prophecy, and you definitely don't understand that Uranus is bringing us with Jupiter these amazing blessings that you already have that you're not looking at. All right, let's do the prayer, and then we'll go right into the mix. Hold on, I'm just putting some cards everywhere. Putting the cards back. It's Virgo season, you know? It'd be really weird if I just smashed all the cards and threw them around. It's a lot nicer when I put the right cards back in the right deck and put them to the side. So I don't have to do that when I'm done. That's the Pisces happening to people. Like, people are like, well, okay, let me do this, and then I'll clean that up later, and I'll figure that out later. Well, you've done that 50 times, so I'm sure at the White House, I know they already found cocaine, but they don't talk about all the Joe Biden poops everywhere. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, I got to go over here. Like, so I'll clean that up later. No, oh, man. So, although, you know, maybe it wasn't cocaine. Maybe it was the powder that created the paper mache Mexican from Peru aliens. And on that note, dear God, our heavenly eternal Father and Mother and Divine, all in one, most powerful, true unified, bringer of all things that are of love and of life. We are all sitting here on this terrestrial place, matrix. To be honest, it doesn't matter what we define it. It matters that we are in our divine truth from you. These are times where things seem way bigger and way crazier than they are. And I know that it's your guidance and your strength that is showing so many of us to not take it so seriously, that you always bring us so many amazing blessings and gifts. And I am so grateful for you, your eternal guidance, your eternal love. You're the one that always shows up. And more importantly, you're the one who gave us just not only access to here, but also gives us access to so many beautiful blessings that we can manifest in this life, that we can do it, and especially when we align it with your mission and purpose. We all have our own unique orders. We all have our own unique gifts. And it's the most best part of why we're here. I appreciate you, Lord, so much. I appreciate all the great things that you have given to me in my life. I appreciate being a father. I appreciate my beautiful fiance. I appreciate the mother that she is for, the daughter that I have that I am forever grateful for. I'm so grateful for all the friends and all the people here at High Vibe and the friends in my life and the family and everybody and all the people that I'm so blessed to love the content on High Vibe. We are so blessed. We all feel so blessed. And it's been truly the best moment of my life. I can't thank you any more than this time ever. And I thank you every day. And I thank you every second. And it just keeps getting better, the thank yous, because you just keep delivering more and more beauty and more happiness and grace. I'm filled up inside, Lord. I know that there are others filled up, and I know that we came up here filled up with love, but our tank's full. And I know that so many are not. I know that they stray from the path of their connection with you. I know they stray from their path of even believing in anything that has got spirit in it. And that's okay. We're here to do it with love. We're not here to force people like the Pope. I will still try to understand that one day, Lord, but I give grace to the Pope too. One day they'll figure out what they're doing over there. But at the end of the day, I know that people are so scared of what's happening or what's going on or what's going to affect them in the physical so much. And it's not so much about transcending that, Lord. It's so much more about connecting with you. It's about getting out of the mind that's stuck in the physical. And really getting out of the mind and connecting with your divine, eternal love and your divine, eternal truth. These are times for people to speak up in their divine, eternal truth. But that divine, eternal truth is not something that is based off some belief or even some sort of ethical system. It's based upon eternal truth that can be one that is not going to see the world or accept a world that is taking people's rights away, taking away the ability for people to find happiness by slamming down their throat and in their consciousness so much that belittles them, so much that makes them feel like they don't have their eternal powers within them. And there's a lot of us here, Lord, that I know you brought us down here to help fully. And that commitment lies 100% in me every day. It does in Sophia. It does in, we'll see with our daughter. I will never expect my daughter to do anything except whatever she feels in her own self. I don't own my daughter. I don't own my fiance. I don't own my friends. I don't own anybody. All I can say that I own is your blessings that you bring me every day. And they show up everywhere. And I find my high self-worth from those. And I am so appreciative that you've given me so much self-worth this life, Lord, because it was so easy. All I had to do was love you and connect with you and follow your path, which had nothing to do like this crazy matrix that they push on TV and they push now on phones and they push on people to be a certain way. I'm so blessed that I found you so young. I'm so blessed that there's been so many that have guided me to you and supported me. And likewise, it's so much of a blessing to support others on their journey too, and to remind them there's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to be scared about. It's our connection, not with you, but our connection with the eternal itself, the eternal love we have for all things, but more importantly too, just the connection with others, the connection with people that are of the same merit, the same values, and more importantly, the same connection. And it's great to be back. I appreciate you, Lord. I thank you every day, and I'm so blessed, and I do not take 1 second of this for granted. I take all of it with the highest honor and the highest integrity and the highest gratitude and thanks, because This is the most amazing thing I could ever do in my life, and I appreciate you so much, Lord. And I send that same out to everybody else out there, too. Thank you so much. Amen. I appreciate you all being here. Of course, this is live. We'll be live right now. I just bought all these tracks, so I've never even played them. That's how I roll here, because I like it to be rolling. I channel it based off the energy of the whatever we're in. So we're just coming out of a new moon in Virgo. We've got Mercury that's stationed direct after that new moon. And here we are, five planets retrograde, coming into eclipse season and Jupiter-Venus square. And my first DJ mixed as a father. I love you all very much. I will see you in the mix.
focus on my, want you to focus on my, focus on my, want you to focus on my body, focus on my, focus on my, want you to focus on my, want you to focus on my body.
giving. It's giving Madonna, Vogue, it's giving life, goals, it's giving Mariah, Eva, it's giving rainbow, era, it's giving Queen, Gaga, it's giving iconic, drama, it's giving Vogue, Vogue. Madonna, Vogue, it's giving life, balls, it's giving Mariah, Eva, it's giving rainbow, era, it's giving cool, Gaga, it's giving iconic, drama, it's giving Vogue,
brothers in the house, what? Brothers in the house. rubbers, over.
Messages transmitted at the request of the United States government. At 12:07 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, numerous unidentified objects of unknown intent and unknown origin were detected at high altitudes over multiple locations of Earth's outer space by the National Radio Astronomy Observatory in San Agustin, New Mexico. These objects are presumed to be some form of controlled aircraft. It is not known if more of these aircraft will arrive, or if they will attempt entering Earth's atmosphere. United States citizens are encouraged to monitor local media outlets, as more updates will follow as information becomes available.
Dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows.
you this chilling challenge. So what's up? To find a way out. Of course, there's always my way.
Can be Jumped out at you from behind the tree, and Grandpa got all excited. And he shook his fist at me and he said, "Boy, you'll be damned to hell." Remember that? Right over there. You used to really be scared.
Johnny.
You're still afraid.
Stop it now. I mean it.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Stop it. You're ignorant.
They're coming for you, Barbara.
Stop it! You're acting like a child!
They're coming for you. Look, there comes one of them now.
Oh, Certainly nice of you to drop by, Mr. Benson.
Cotton. Everybody calls me Cotton.
Oh, yeah.
Getting into April. Just about time for old Satan to start stirring. Yes, and just about that time.
Satan.
1,500 odd pounds of the meanest, wickedest animal this side of Hades.
Sounds like a grizzly.
Looks like a grizzly. The folks around here are beginning to think he's the devil himself.
Well, I've had trouble with grizzlies before. They won't give you any trouble.
Well, that's just what. Satan don't wait for no invitation. He comes around looking for it.
Winchester 4440 ought to take care of it.
It hasn't yet. See? Oh, I've been lucky. I've seen his work. He kills just for the wicked fun of it.
What about traps?
That devil's busted up every trap was ever laid for. He gets the bait out, too. And that beast ain't Lucifer in person. He's sure his first cousin. He's got the heart of a cougar, and he can outthink any man ever born. You better believe that. Speaking of the devil, if it ain't Jed Curry. He likes to get what he wants. And he sure wants this land. Don't let him spook you.
But he's gonna spook me, Cotton.
How do you want it? need that extra push.
I'm going to six. You know what we do?
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly. One louder.
Why don't you just make 10 louder and make 10 be the top number and make that a little louder?
These go to 11.
Now, if you're not prepared to do that,
broke niggas wanna check. She a tight, no snack, just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch,
just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch,
just bought a Cadillac.
And Corn Pop was a bad dude. And Corn Pop was a bad dude. And Corn Pop was a bad dude. And he ran, 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 he ran a bunch of bad boys.
Rich boy sell it quick, book niggas wanna check. She a tight, no snack, just bought a Cadillac. She a tight, no snake, just bought a Cadillac.
And he ran, 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 he ran a bunch of bad boys. And I did, and back in those days, you sure how things have changed? One of the things you had to use, if you used pomade in your hair, you had to wear a bathing cap.
Rich boy said it quick,
and so he was up on the board, wouldn't listen to me. I said, hey, Cadillac, you, off the board, I'm coming up and drag you off. And Corn Pop was a bad dude. Pop was a bad dude. Bad dude. Bad dude. Was a bad. Was a bad. Was a bad dude. And he ran a bunch of bad boys.
Human cyborg relations.
You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
my Italian confidential secretary. My name is Alok.
A lot of vagina.
Come again.
A lot of vagina.
Ah, sorry, I'm just not getting it. Sound like you said your name was a lot of, never mind.
Clay. Now, you worked there for about a year, gaining valuable experience, and remarkably, for a newscaster, a personal following of high school students. Spring 1952, your father agreed, and your radio-television career ought to be into a larger market area, and he sets up an interview for you with the manager of station W. He's home in that city where today he's vice president of Triangle Publications, radio and television division, is that former manager, Roger Cliff.
Is conducting a troubleshoot test of the entire system. Somehow, while the party was in progress, an unidentified frequency has been existing in the system for some time. And while many of you comprehend, this frequency is and has become a threat to our society as we know it. This frequency has been used by a secret society in conjunction with Lucifer to lure and prey on innocent partygoers with hypnotism, synchroprism, tricknology, lies, scandal, and pornography. While the party is still in progress, we will keep you updated on our current status.
7th and Adelaide, barricade situation.
Turn it up from the bottom to the top. When you see me in the club. when we're in the dark. And we're all alone, no darling. I can share my love with you, but no one knows. Yeah, when life gets hard, you are all I know, no darling. When we're in the dark.
Some believed everything and waiting with bated breath to hear me confess it all. They're just dying to have me declare that everything said is true and that I got what I deserve. Wouldn't that be easy? It's all so simple. You and I both know each other, that's simple, not in politics and money. But you wouldn't believe the worst without evidence, would you? You wouldn't rush to judgments without facts, would you? Anyway, all this presumption made for such an unsatisfying ending. And to think it could have been such a memorable send-off. I mean, if you and I have learned nothing else these past years, it's that in life and art, nothing should be off the table. We weren't afraid, not of what we said, not of what we did, and we're still not afraid. We don't like the price for that. If I didn't pay the price for the things we both know I did do, I'm certainly not going to pay the price for the things I didn't do. Oh, of course, they're going to say I'm being disrespectful, not playing by the rules. Like I ever played by any of the rules before.
Yeah. Thank you.